There's a world that was meant for our eyes to see. To the ends of the earth would you follow me? Hey there, we're John and Laura, and in 2018, we bought a Sprinter motorhome and a Jeep and started to travel. These are our stories. We call it Road Camp. Why don't you come along?
You did notice I got the same shirt on. I know that. Okay, so it's clean though. We have a laundry here at this RV park. It's pretty nice. See, there's the view from our front porch. But we don't have a porch, but sounds better. But if you're new to RVing, we're here down by the water, which is kind of cool. One of the drawbacks is, since we're downhill and close to water, we have no sewer. So they have a handy setup here at this park though. They have somebody that comes by, don't you wish you had this job, in a little truck with a little tank and a little pump, and he takes care of all your problems. He charges you for it, but you're willing to pay anything. Okay, so I was showering this morning. I noticed in the bottom of the shower that the water wasn't going out. That means my tank's full. So time to call the man. But anyway, if you're new to RVing, there's lots of things to learn. So that's one of them. And another one is, let me show you about the slide. We've talked about slides before, but the RV looks like this when the slide's out. And so it comes out about 30 inches. So it takes a 8-foot RV and makes it about, I don't know, 11 feet wide. So it comes all the way out, and that gives you a much bigger inside. And I'll come back a little bit later and show you what it looks like inside with the slide out and then with the slide in, but makes a huge difference. So we're going to call these informational videos RV in 101. And so you might pick up some tidbits, but most of you know a lot of this because you do some RVing, but some of you don't. But high tide today is at 11 o'clock, and I'm embarrassed to say that it's 11 o'clock and we're just leaving the RV. So last night when we were here, we walked out probably 150, 200 feet from where we are right now. And so low tide today is around 5 o'clock in the afternoon, so in about 6 hours. So I'll try to get a shot if we get back in time from all of our adventures and show you how much the tide moves here. But so this is the picture at high tide, and with any luck, shortly after this you'll see the picture of low tide. Had to wait till this evening. It's about 5:30, and I think where I'm standing, it's probably 6, 7, 8, 10 feet lower. I think the tide moves about 12 feet in elevation. None of these rocks in the foreground here are able to be seen at high tide. Well, it's time to go explore. We're going back into Bar Harbor and gonna go into Acadia and try to find something to eat.
Please, let me grow old with you. After everything we've been through, what's left to prove? So please,
said we were going in search of food, and guess what? Lolly brought her own food. What are we having here, Lolly? Tell me
we
what
we are having. Charcuterie.
What, charcuterie? How do you spell that?
I'm not sure.
What is that?
Ham. It's sort of frozen.
That's better than
and
being
overdone. And then some manchego cheese, some camper made orzo pasta salad, and tomatoes from our garden.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah.
And there's the Bar Harbor.
Let's see. Not a bad place to have lunch.
Mm-hmm. We're not sure where the bar is that you can walk out on, but it's high tide. So.
High tide. Low tide's at 5 o'clock. We have 4 hours in our
parking meter. It took us about an hour and a half to find a place to park, but that just helped us work up our appetite. I may be stretching the hour and a half. We come complete with our own chairs. They come out of this bag. I'm not sure how they do it.
It's a tiny bag.
Mm-hmm. Fits in there. But excuse me, but I need to go back to eating my charcuterie. Talk to you soon. There goes the Margaret Todd, taking sail for the afternoon cruise. We're thinking about hitting the sunset cruise this evening. I mean, we got a parking spot. As in George Costanza would say, it'd be horrible to leave a good parking spot.
What about that spot I got?
Yeah, I saw the spot.
Cruise, a 3-hour cruise.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip that started from this tropic port aboard this tiny ship. The mate was a mighty sailing man, the skipper brave and sure. 5 passengers set sail that day for a 3-hour tour. A 3-hour tour. The weather started getting rough, the tiny ship was tossed. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the minnow would be lost. The minnow would be lost. The ship's aground on the shore of this uncharted desert isle, with Gilligan, the skipper too. The millionaire and his wife, the movie star.
So, do you need the defibrillator? I see it over there.
Yeah.
How the tide rushes in and covers footprints in the sand, as my hopes erased and carried out of my hands. How the tides ebb and flow as driftwood tossed upon the shore, and my heart's cast aside and lost evermore. Yet though the ocean with waves unending covers the earth, yet is there loss after all. For whatever drifts from one place is with the tide to another brought, and there's naught lost beyond recall, which cannot be found if sought. Cannot be found if sought.